So, how long should I stay in SOC before switching to malware analysis? I get this sometimes in emails that people who are starting, who are in SOC or in IT administration or at the beginning of cybersecurity, they tell me that, oh, I'm planning to stay in SOC for 3 years, and after that, I will have an opportunity to move into malware analysis. And I always wonder why this idea came from. Mostly it's because that people in IT administration and in SOC and network security, they always believe in in certificates and the number of years as a way to move from one field to another. So you stay in IT administration for 2 3 years, you take some of the courses like A plus or Microsoft certificates or things like that, and then you start to move into cybersecurity. Or people who take CCNA, for example, they become network engineers, and then after some time, after some years, and with some certificates, they move into network security. But when it comes to malware analysis, it's a completely different field, really, really completely different from SOC analysis and network security. There are some things in common, of course, but most of the skills that you have to learn from reverse engineering, from understanding assembly, from monitoring a malware, from understanding what's the meaning behind this behavior, all of that things are not really similar to SOC analysis. And the years of experience that you are spending in SOC analysis or in network security doesn't really add to your resume when it comes to malware analysis. It's like switching career completely. So when you should start learning malware analysis, you should start right now. Basically, if you are interested in malware analysis and you really want to build yourself in that field, then you just do the switch, because any day you are spending in a job that you don't like, you're actually wasting it. You could have been learning, or you could have been already working in malware analysis. Hope that helps, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.